All right, so welcome. So these are just a couple questions to get people to this conversation we're having next Wednesday. The first thing we just want to make clear, because this is a conversation on a meaningful career, is just a couple thoughts from you on a distinction between success and meaning.
Wow, success and meaning, that's a good question. Well, I think someone can be quite successful by societal terms and make a lot of money and receive a lot of accolades and have zero connection to their purpose of being alive. So I think anyone who's living a life of meaning is actually the most successful.
Another really big compromise that sometimes people feel as they're starting to journey on their career is that they need to make a distinction between money or being in service. And if you had to think about your own career as a road trip and a journey, how did you approach that dichotomy? Did you view it as a dichotomy, or how did you approach
that? You know, you're making a grave mistake by having an actor and an artist talking to the business community, because when I got started, I didn't really care about money at all. I wanted to be a theater artist and an actor. I wanted to make beautiful works of art that transported people and told important stories. Eventually I was like, maybe it would be nice to eventually somehow buy a house. You know, that might be something to think about. So then I started thinking about doing a little more film and television rather than just theater. Again, I think that if you're connected to your purpose, to your vision, to your mission, doors will open. And also the societal pressure to make money and familial pressure to make money kind of fades away in importance.
One other thing that people can get stuck on in their career is that they need to really focus on competing with other people and making sure that they are extremely distinct from others. There's also an opportunity for us to actually learn about who we are and our distinctions by being in relationship to others and working within teams. And I wondered if you could just speak to that dichotomy of competition with others versus learning what your gifts are within your fields through working with others.
Amazing question. Really so good. I love it. You know, the first thing that pops to mind is that humanity is at a crisis point and at a big area of transition, going from a way of working that worked for humanity for the first 100,000 years of its life. Competition, setting yourself apart, putting yourself over someone, you know, competing, contest, fighting, alpha-ing someone else. This worked, you know, it built empires, you know, it created the Caesars and Alexander the Great and the great leaders of the nation states. And it got us to a certain point as a species on this planet. And it's not working anymore. You know, it only takes you so far. And it certainly doesn't take you farther or deeper in terms of well-being. And it certainly doesn't provide for the well-being of, you know, 7-8 billion people inhabiting this planet. So we have to shift our way of doing things at a personal level. And this is also reflected on a societal level. And what you said is exactly right. You know, cooperation, community, connection, these are the new kind of focus points that we have to strive toward, again, individually and collectively.
All right. So last question is, a lot of times when we are trying to set a vision for ourselves and our careers, we have some kind of goal, look, image, and the process of getting there is one where we actually have to hit unexpected things, hit rock bottom, hit turning points, and things that tell us, hey, it's not going to look like what you thought it was going to look like. But it takes a lot of grit and resilience to move through those periods and not just view them as complete failures, losses, or slaps in the face. So what did it look like for you, and what does it look like for you to meet the unexpected and also trials and adversities along your journey?
Yeah, so listen, if you read any business book by a business leader, they're always going to talk about trials, adversity, hitting bottom, you know, having to completely reshape their philosophy to get to where they are. You know, you don't really read the books of the person of like, I went to an Ivy League school and I got my MBA and I started at my job and then I was incredibly successful.
It all worked.
It all worked out. So the important thing, and I tell this to kids, to younger kids, is, you know, there's a lot of pressure, at least in the US, I don't know if there is in Europe, to like have everything figured out super young. So to know what track you're going on at age 19, to have your major figured out, to have your internships perfectly line up. So you're 22, you have your degree, you're getting an advanced degree, and you're on this course at 25, 26. I always tell people, like, your 20s is your chance to just make a lot of mistakes. And that's what the 20s are about. You just are going to make a ton of mistakes, and that's okay. And you're going to learn and grow. But there's a ton of pivot points along the way. And anyone who's had any success, both externally from a business standpoint, and I guess one could say internally from a spiritual standpoint, because anytime you read the books of the great spiritual leaders, they always describe, you know, crisis converting into victory, right? Into setbacks, trials, and failures, learning from those and rising from the ashes. It's both a spiritual missive and a professional one.
I did say those last. I do have one last one. Fill in the blank. Love of X kept me going. And when you think of your own journey of building a meaningful career.
Wow. Love of X keep me going. I guess I would say for me, it's storytelling. You know, there's incredible psychological studies that have shown how humans are natural storytellers, and that storytelling does something and it changes our brain. When you hear a story, your compassion actually increases. There's a beauty and richness to that. And I believe the making of art is a spiritual act, and I believe it's an act of service. And even as something as silly as The Office has brought a lot of solace to a lot of people during some really difficult times. And I love being a part of that process.
Wow, thanks so much, Rainn. That was awesome. These are beautiful things. Can't wait to break this up into a couple of parts.
Yeah.